Today we are in a space that is in the building at 3655 Olive Street. It is the Dana Brown Center, and we are proud to be announcing the formation of the Nine Network for Public Media. Now, when you announce the formation of a new entity like this, normally we all would be standing here with shovels ready to break ground, but we're standing inside the building, and we are similarly breaking ground on this new activity called the Nine Network for Public Media. With me today is Jack Schreiber, the board chair of KETC Channel 9 and the president of Commerce Bank.
Just a couple of comments, I think, Jack and everyone. First of all, I think we all know that Channel 9 is a great television station, has been for more than five decades. But this is really a great example, I believe, of how we can bring this station to the community and all the resources of this station in ways beyond even television. It's a great investment in the community. This will be a great opportunity for a lot of young people to get engaged in this media. And thank you very much to the Dana Brown Foundation for making it possible with their kind gift. We couldn't be more pleased. We're looking very much forward to how this takes shape. It just looks outstanding, and we'll look forward to it as time goes on here and it gets constructed. So,
great. Thank you, Jack. Also with us is KETC board member Randy Schilling, who is also the president of Quilogy and is very involved in youth in our community as well as new technology.
Yeah, Jack, this is a great opportunity for to get engaged with our youth, especially around math, engineering, technology, and science. Way for the children and the community to get hands-on experience working with some of the latest technology, and also how to share that with the rest of the public, and what are they doing in their local schools, and capturing that in unique ways that we can do now with technology. So it's a very exciting opportunity, and it's exciting to see it come together today. So it's neat.
Thank you, Randy, for being with us. And our special guest today is Paula Kerger, who is the president and CEO of PBS. And Paula has been speaking around the country about the engagement of youth and how we as public broadcasters might enter the world of new technology. And it's our pleasure for her to be part of this announcement.
It's very exciting to be here. I think what defines public broadcasting is our commitment to localism and our engaging with local community. And as I travel around the country, there are a handful of stations that really do sit at the leading edge of what public broadcasting should be, and that is KETC. And so it's exciting to see this new initiative moving forward to create a physical space where the community can come together, can embrace new technology, and look at ways to serve St. Louis. And I'll be looking at this as a model as we roll out our work across the country.
And also with us today, we are proud to have David Diener, the chairman of the Dana Brown Charitable Trust. We are here today not only in this space but in this building because of the generosity of Dana Brown over the years. 10 years ago, the Dana Brown Charitable Trust made a significant gift that enabled us to build this building in this location. And we're here today at a space that was left unfinished, thinking that there would be a future for new forms of communications going forward. Thank you, David Diener, and the other trustees of the Dana Brown Charitable Trust.
Thank you, Jack. On behalf of the Dana Brown Charitable Trust and U.S. Bank, I'm thrilled and honored to be here. Dana Brown loved children. He had none of his own, but he wanted his fortune to go for the betterment and the enrichment of children's lives in the St. Louis area. And what better way to introduce the 21st century in media than the Channel 9 Media Center here. And we are just thrilled, and I know Dana Brown would be too if he were here, to be able to help the kids of St. Louis learn what's new in media for the 21st century.
Well, thank you, David, and thank you to the vision and the generosity of the Dana Brown Charitable Trust. And also with us is Heather Woofter, who is the architect and designer along with Sung Ho. They are a team of architects out of Washington University, and it was our hope that this space would appeal to the youth of our community, and because you work so closely with youth, it was partly your vision that allowed us to create a space that we hope will be welcoming to the youth of our community.
Well, when Jack first came to us with the project, one of the things that he talked about the most was this idea of a network and these interconnections between different peoples of varying skill levels and varying interests. And I think that's what really motivated us in the work. We started to think about network and communication as being one of the critical issues in the project. And so we tried to kind of carry that out spatially within the environment. We have different anchors that are permanent parts of the space. The Beacon newspaper, for instance, is a set of very experienced journalists and editors, and they provide an anchor for the younger people who are working with new media. They also get influenced by the younger people as well in their work. And we also have a set of educators that are working with the community and with education and bringing teachers into the space to make it an active environment where they can teach teachers, high school students, college students, new ways of working with media. And so that they also provide an anchor to the space. And so we thought about it as having a communication wall where these different groups of people could come together and start to begin to discuss this information and new ways of working with media around the communication wall. And on the opposite side, we try to leave the space as open as possible, opening it up to the double-headed space beyond and the glass, in order to achieve kind of a lightness, a sense of openness. The desk configurations in the space are meant to be flexible so that we can bring in different groups of people for collaborative activities. It could also be transformed into a large kind of auditorium space where we could watch large filming or documentaries. So I think we've tried to maintain some of the inspiring words that we heard from Jack regarding communication and network and work that into an idea about how to build a community within a particular space.